All right, there are calls for stiffer penalties for predatory tow companies following a story from the 7 investigators.
On Friday, we first showed you how a Redford company tried to charge one woman $9,000 just to tow her SUV.
A $9,000 charge, that is a problem. But is the solution to get government involved to make more laws so that that doesn't happen? That is the question. Welcome back to Here's the Deal. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification icon, give it a thumbs up, and share it with everybody you know.
Now, I felt it necessary to talk about this because within the body of this article, and there is a grave injustice that's happening right here, don't get me wrong, but the knee-jerk reaction on this is we need to get government involved and they need to make more rules and policies and laws for the rest of us so this kind of stuff doesn't happen. I'm gonna go ahead and play this news report. It's a $9,000 towing bill prompts calls for stronger predatory towing laws in Michigan. And even in the body of the text, they say that even other tow truck companies are telling legislators that they need to create more laws to keep this predatory towing behavior at bay. I wonder why that is. Listen to this.
All right, there are calls for stiffer penalties for predatory tow companies following a story from the 7 investigators.
On Friday, we first showed you how a Redford company tried to charge one woman $9,000 just to tow her SUV.
It was more than the cost of her vehicle, guys. The towing company arrives on the scene and just tows her car away. There's no written or verbal agreement saying, okay, this is how much it's going to cost you. Do you agree to the terms of the conditions before we pick up your car? This is why I'm calling this criminal activity, because there was no written agreement. And when you're holding somebody's property, and the only way they can release their property, and it's damaged property at that, because she got involved in this car pileup on this freeway. But when you're holding somebody's property, and you're basically telling them, unless you give us this exorbitant amount of money, you can't get your property. That's criminal activity. Why? Because that tow truck company and the members thereof and the families that belong to that people that own that tow truck company would not want that happening to them. This is a violation of the golden rule. Do to others what you would want done to you. Conversely, don't do to others what you wouldn't want done to you. That makes it criminal activity.
After she was caught in a pileup on I-696. Now, experts say the tow should have cost less than $400.
And now even the towing industry is calling for changes to Michigan law.
There you go. The towing industry is calling for changes to Michigan law. Guys, this is basically the towing industry and other people who don't want to get scammed like this woman got scammed. And I understand the knee-jerk reaction, but what they're basically saying is, hey, are you from the government? We need your help. The 9 most terrifying words in the English language are still, I'm from the government and I'm here to help. The terrifying response is, oh, you're from the government? We need your help. Guys, a government that's big enough to give you everything you want will always be big enough, and they'll make sure they're big enough to take everything you've got. There is a free market answer to this problem right here. We'll get to that in a minute.
7 investigator Ross Jones with the very latest.
No way and no how can you justify $9,000.
After a lifetime in the towing industry, Bill Byers thought he'd seen it all until he saw our story of a driver hit with an almost $10,000 tow bill just to have her car towed a few miles.
Have you ever done a bill like this
in
your life?
No. That's just blatantly taking advantage of somebody just because they can.
Since our story for...
Yeah, because they can. I mean, talk about being between a rock and a hard place. This woman needs that minivan back so that she can go to her job, so that she can make money and support her family. But the tow truck company won't release it unless she pays more money than she actually probably owes on the vehicle.
First aired, we have been flooded with reaction on social media and emails from drivers with their own towing tales of woe. And now, the story has gotten the attention of Michigan State Police looking into what happened to Kelly Rockwell and perhaps other drivers stuck on I-696. Kelly assumed that 10G, the tower that showed up quickly to the pileup, was called there by state police. But they weren't. 10G wouldn't tell us how they arrived there, but by the time they were done towing Kelly's Ford Escape, her $2,200 tow bill had swelled to $9,048. Barry Foster is the president of the Detroit Towers Association.
A lot of these guys, they ride around with scanners in their trucks, and they know that the accident happened, so they're trying to get to that scene to see what's going on and beat the police authorized tower to the scene.
Companies like 10...
Now, that's alarming right there. A police authorized tower. Why would the police, why would state agents and functionaries work in concert with towing companies? And as I understand it, there's like a rotation schedule. And correct me if I'm wrong, Gypsies said he worked for a towing company for 20 years. But it seems to me that the state agencies are working with the tow company. My question is, and I don't have the answer to this, do the tow companies give a percentage of the impound fee and the towing fee and the profit that they make coming into their business? Does that go anywhere near the coffers of the state? Like, does the police department benefit from those tow charges and those impound fees?
NG are the exception.
Because if they do, that sounds like a racket to me. Because it sounds like police are incentivized to have your vehicle towed. Not only are they incentivized to have your vehicle towed, they get to write the ticket, the citation, or whatever, and then get with the towing company and have these police-authorized towing companies. And if, because I don't know, if a percentage of that towing fee and that impound fee that that customer has to, you know, forced customer has to pay for, if a percentage of it goes to the police, then I can see a monetary incentive for police to actually call a particular tow truck driver.
Not the rule, Foster says. But they're not the only bad actors in the business. He says drivers in Kelly Rockwell's position should insist on using a tow company that's authorized by police. They operate on a fee schedule that won't allow for ridiculous markups.
Basically, if you're not asking that tower if he's a police authorized tower or a recommended company, you're basically giving them an open checkbook.
After first trying to charge $9,000, 10G later cut down the price to $2,500.
Can you see the tow truck company? By the way, the tow truck company is called 10G Towing and Recovery. And stay tuned, because we're going to talk about this. We're going to talk about the free market solution to this. And it does not involve in any way getting the legislative process and legislators involved in creating more laws, which always take away more freedoms and more wealth, or at least sets up the power for a future more powerful state. So it's called 10G Towing. And can you imagine them sitting there going, well, I'll tell you what, today and today only, we're going to cut that. We're going to reduce that $9,048 down to $2,500 today and today only. Dial before midnight tonight. What a scam.
10G later cut down the price to $2,500 after we interviewed Kelly. Her insurer, Progressive, then agreed to pay.
What would you have charged for a tow like this?
Somewhere around $350, $400.
Rockwell's
$350, $400. Now, it depends on where they're. Are you towing at 20, 50 miles in the ice and the snow? It seems like there'd be a sliding scale there. It's like, yeah, we got to charge a little bit more right here because our tow truck driver, it took him a long time to get out there. It was pretty torrential. You know, we did it in the middle of a blizzard or whatever. But $350 and $400 for a tow seems pretty exorbitant to me still. I mean, think about it. I mean, yeah, they got to pay for their trucks and they got to pay for the insurance and they got to pay for the fuel and they got to pay for all this kind of stuff. But $350, that's a pretty good haul. Let's say it takes you 3 hours to do that for $350. You're making about $115 an hour. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Cha-ching.
Says
raised by gypsies. Who? How long were you a tow truck driver, gypsies? Like 20 years. I asked gypsies if it's true that there's some kind of kickback that the police department gets from the towing company for impound fees and towing fees. And he says, it's been a racket that's been going on for a long time. This is where the local Masons come in. And then he says, under the table they do. Because I asked, do police get a cut? And he said, under the table they do. First, you have to be a part of the local Freemasons. Is that right? That would be an interesting investigation in and of itself. I wonder if it's like that everywhere. That would be very interesting because you got all these creepy windowless Masonic temples all over the place. And like, if you're not in the Brotherhood, you don't get that scratch on your back that you really wanted. This can open up a whole bunch of can of worms that I am not, you know, stuff that I'm not privy to.
He was contacted by Michigan State Police, who interviewed her about what happened. Right now in Michigan, it is illegal for tow companies to solicit drivers at the scene.
Now, as a potential tow truck driver, I'd be looking at this going, come on, snow. Come on, inclement weather. All I'm seeing is $350, $400 bills sitting out there on the road just waiting to be picked up. And then you got this whole fleet of vehicles and like seven of you arrive on the scene charging $350 to $400 a pop. Just laughing all the way to the impound lot.
If an accident, but the fine for doing so is only $1,000. Tonight, Barry Foster and others say stories like this are evidence that the penalties should be more severe.
Tonight, a Michigan State Police spokesman says they do not believe 10G broke any criminal laws in this case. Reached by phone, 10G declined comment.
It depends on what you want to define as a crime. I mean, it seems like if you're going to charge somebody that you didn't have an agreement with, somebody has your property in their possession, okay? And they're not going to give you your property unless you pay 9,000 frickin' bucks. How can you not see that as somebody being victimized clearly? I mean, this is like clear cut victimization. Now, somebody could go, well, that's dangerous freedom over peaceful slavery, but it's something that this tow truck company is doing to this woman that they wouldn't want done to them and they wouldn't want done to the one of their family. They would be outraged if the tow truck driver found out that his girlfriend got her vehicle towed to another impound lot by another tow truck company and they weren't going to release his girlfriend's car until she paid, coughed up $9,000, he'd be outraged. He would feel victimized. But he's going to do that to somebody else. So saying that there's not criminal activity just because somebody didn't break a law and now we need to have laws in place is just brain dead to me. You're clearly taking advantage of somebody. You're clearly charging them something you shouldn't be charging that you wouldn't want charged yourself. You clearly victimized somebody and you engaged in predatory towing. So how do we correct this? If not for making laws that keep this from happening, guys, laws won't keep this from happening. There will be people out there breaking laws and still creating victims. We've seen that time and time again. But what you can do is this. I did a Google search for 10G towing. It's literally called, and I looked it up under this exact name, and a couple of news, unless the news got their name wrong, or unless 10G Towing changed their name, or if they took down their presence from the internet, something is amiss because you can't find 10G Towing in this part of Michigan right here, Redford, Michigan. And I'll show you that I've got the exact, because you see their letterhead, you see the invoice that they wrote this lady for $9,000. I'll show you this in a second, but if you look up 10G Towing, and you can see my 10G Towing and Recovery in Redford, Michigan, and where I got that was this screenshot right here. This is the actual road service bill that they gave to this lady for $9,000. It says 10G Towing and Recovery LLC, 26120 Grand River Avenue, Redford, Michigan, 48240. It's got the phone number. So I looked up the right thing, but you can't find it. It's not, it doesn't come up. Look, you got KTAC, North Redford Towing and Transport. Did they change their name? Did they pull their presence off the internet because they got so many phone calls from this news article? I don't know, but you can't find it. You can't find it on here. But you know what you can't? There's A1 Towing. I don't see 10G Towing. It's not in here. So I wanted to look it up so we could get, well, we got the phone number, but the free market answer to this is, hey, let's give Buyer's Record Service our business or any other record service that has, look, they have a 4.8 star rating. That's this guy right here. Let's see. That's this guy that said, I wouldn't have charged that. Where is he? Where is this guy? Yeah, there it is. There's this record service guy. So why don't we give the free market answer to this is, hey, 10G Towing and Recovery needs to go out of business. Well, how do we do that? Well, if we ever need a tow truck, we're going to make sure we get Buyers or North Redford Towing. Let's see, or Page Towing and Recovery LLC has 4.8 stars. Go with the highest. That's what I like about the Google star rating. Can it be abused? Yeah. Can people like 10G Towing and police departments erase negative feedback? Yeah. that's probably not a good idea to keep that as an option on the table, because you really want to see the positives and negatives so you can get a fully orbed view of who you're dealing with and who you might want to do business with or might not want to do business with. So the free market answer to this is not, hey, let's get legislators to make more laws. That's always detrimental to society and increases state power. So why don't we engage in a free market solution to this problem? And that is, hey, let's give buyers records. So he seems like a good guy. And maybe we can talk him down from that. Say, hey, I saw you on the news and you wanted like $350. How about $275? Can we negotiate? And businessmen will negotiate, because you know what's better than making money? Having a good reputation in your society. Don't ask legislators to create more laws that one day will work. Oh, it may work for you today, but it may work against you tomorrow. And criminals who don't like and obey laws, they'll find a way around the law and they'll stick it to you even more. So the answer to this is, oh, and another thing is too, I actually looked up, and what's funny about this is you can actually see this building. I looked up this address. You can see it right here, 26120 West Grand River Avenue, from this right here, 26120 Grand River Avenue. This is West Grand River Avenue, but see this building right here where my mouse is hovering over? You can see that when they said that they tried to reach out to 10G Towing, they couldn't get in touch with them, and they actually showed a little clip of that, the front of that building. You guys probably saw it. I'm scrolling here to try to find it. Yeah, I don't see it. Let's see.
$1,000. Tonight, Barry Foster and others say stories like this are evidence that the penalties should be more.
Yeah, I can't find it, but it was the same image that they put up. This is possibly 10G Towing, but look, you can't. Their name is not even on there. Their name is not even on there. It's near Mag Motor Sales on Grand River Avenue, West Grand River Avenue. So not sure what happened here with 10G Towing. If they just said, hey, you know what? We're getting too many phone calls. Let's change our name. Let's take our presence off the internet or whatever. But looks like they're trying to hide from the shame that they're getting, because everybody knows it's wrong. Everybody knows you try to make a quick buck off of these victims here. And that's another lesson here is always ask questions. Go, okay, hey, did the police call you out here? Are you coming out here by yourself? What is this going to cost me? What are the terms of the agreement? Put that in writing. Never hurts to ask that. What if you go, screw you, then I'm not going to tow your vehicle. You can leave it here and rot for all I care. It's like, okay, I'll make another call. Because you obviously have a lot of options in this town. Look at all the towing companies in this town. There's a lot of options for towing companies. That's the free market solution to something. You don't want the government involved in your business. You don't want them making more laws. It makes you less free. Leave your thoughts about this. I want to hear what you have to say.